All right, here we are. Now let's go to 1 John chapter 5, right up here at the top. See that? We're going to click this link right there. See that? Just highlight it. Click. There we are, 1 John 5, KJV. All right. Whoso believeth that Yeshua is the anointed is born of the Most High, and everyone that loveth him loveth him also that is begotten of him. All right. Whoever, or that word, replace that word with accepted. We don't do the word believe. That's a satanic word. Right. Whoso confesseth, or whoso accepteth that Yeshua is the anointed, is born of the Most High. Whoso accepteth. Right. And everyone that loveth him that begot, loveth him also that is begotten of him. In other words, him that is begotten of him, he's talking about men. The Most High created man, us. And we love our neighbor, and we love one another. The only way we love one another is telling the truth. But then Paul basically goes on to say this. Since how we're out from underneath the law, and the sin nature isn't all rising up in us anymore because of that, as strong as it used to, because it's the power of the law that causes the sin nature to rise in men. Right? Now that we're not under the law, he says, do treat each other nicely and be kind, say kind things, do good things. All right? But that's not the basis of our salvation. It's not. Our lives that we live is not the basis of our salvation. And raising our hand and accepting Jesus because we had some smooth preacher who's so suave and make you feel guilty about all the drugs you're doing on the ground and give you testimony that if you come to our church, you'll be cured, we'll pray for it and get you off your drugs and we'll have a better life and all that. They just sunk you even deeper than where you were at. You were better where you were at. They just sunk you even deeper. Even though they might help you get off drugs, they just sunk you even deeper. Pile higher and deeper, man. By this we know that we love the children of the Most High when we love the Most High and keep His commandments. What are His commandments? Brand new commandments. It's not the Ten Commandments. It's not the summary of the Ten Commandments. It's love one another. And that summarizes two new commandments. Love the Most High and love your brother. All right. For this is the love of the Most High, that we keep His commandments. And His commandments are not grievous. In other words, they're easy. They're not a heavy burden. They are not impossible to perform. They're possible. All we have to do is speak truth out of our mouth to a brother. Love one another. Tell them about the sin. Tell them that the word "the" is missing. 99% of all Bibles on earth for the word sin. It's supposed to be the sin. And that's a specific sin. It's the only sin Satan did to get himself kicked out. Trying to be like the Most High. Read Isaiah chapter 14, verse 11 through 14. Nah, 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 nah. Tell them the story. Tell them the story. It might take 1,000 times before it finally sinks in, but keep telling. Besides, it's good practice for us, too, to repeat things over and over and over again. All right? That would become firm and established and confident, able, skillful to teach. Pull a man out of the fire. Come on out there, brother. For whatsoever is born of the Most High overcometh the world, and this is the victory that overcometh the world, even our faith. All right? Even our faith. All right. Faith is just another word for knowing the truth. Faith is just another word for looking forward to the eternal life. Right? Just another word. It's a manifold wisdom. Another word that explains all the same thing. He who overcometh the world, who is he that overcometh the world but he that accepteth that Yeshua is the Son of the Most High? Not that you raise your hand and accept it. Blah, 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 blah. I accept Jesus into my life. Blah, blah, blah. I accept him. Blah, 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 blah. Preacher told me all I have to do is accept it. Blah, 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 blah. Okay. He who overcometh the world, but he that believeth, he that accepteth that Yeshua is the Son of the Most High. Right? How do we accept him? The only way we can accept him is hear what the real story is. Then we accept that story. And when we accept that story, that's accepting him. Because he is the story. He's the word. He's the living word. He is all this right here in this book right here. Oh, man. You never heard anything like this before, have you? Yeah. You're in for some eternal life. Keep listening to this, and especially if you accept it. Okay. This is he that came by water and blood, even Yeshua the Anointed. Not by water only, but water and blood. And it is the Spirit that beareth witness, because the Spirit is truth. Yeah. Water and blood. Water and blood, man. Right? This body has water and blood in it, man. In other words, he came in the flesh. He's most high in a man's body. He came with water and blood. Water and blood, man. Remember when the soldier stuck the sword in the Yeshua's side? What does it say came out? Water and blood. Ah. For there are three that bear record in heaven: the Father, the Word, and the Holy Ghost. And these three are one. The Word, the Father, the Most High, His Word right here, and His Holy Spirit that He sends into our hearts. And there are three that bear witness on earth: the Spirit, and the water, and the blood. All right, the Spirit, the water, and the blood. The Spirit's in our bodies here on earth. It's in our water bodies. They have blood in them. Spirit, the water, and the blood. And His Holy Spirit is in us, and He was in a man's body that had water and blood. So He did for us in a body of water and blood what Adam failed. Formed His own commandment, fulfilled it. Okay. If we receive the witness of men, the witness of the Most High is greater, for this is the witness of the Most High that He has testified of His Son. He that believeth on the Son, the Most High hath witness, or accepteth the Son hath the witness in himself, and he that accepteth not the Most High has made him a liar, because he accepteth not the record. He accepted not the record that the Most High gave of His Son. The record, man. Here he's talking about the record. There's three that bear record in heaven, and three that bear record on earth. Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, the water, the blood, and the Spirit. The Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit in the heavenlies, and the water, blood, and the Spirit on the earth. Okay? And if we don't know all about that to accept it, we're a liar. Going around telling everybody we can love our neighbors as self, karma, good rule, and all that crud. And this is the record that the Most High has given to us, eternal life. And this is the record that the Most High has given to us, eternal life. And this life is in His Son. Right? His Son is the record, man. His Son is the record. His Son came down, the Most High, in a man's body, called Himself His own Son. This is the record. What did He do? Performed His commandment. He performed fulfilling love His neighbors as Himself, as ourselves. Only He can do such a thing. He's perfect. He can do everything. Even perform His own perfect command that He gave on purpose, knowing full well that mankind could not perform it. It's only a tool to show us that we can't be like the Most High. And thus we'll be able to relate that what Satan did. He tried to be like the Most High. So the Most High gave us a commandment from the get-go to Adam and Eve to help us to see it. And then Satan tricked Adam and Eve's children, known as the nation of Israel, met Moses at Mount Sinai when he brought the Ten Commandments out in Sinai 13 ordinances and said, read the crying, written contract, and Israel volunteered to put themselves under it. They should have said, oh, no way we can do that. All right. He that hath the Son hath life, and he that hath not the Son of the Most High hath not life. These things have I written unto you that you accept on the name, that you accept the Most High's Son, on the name of the Most High. Right? That ye may go, that you may have your eternal life, and that ye may accept on the name of the Most High. Accept the Son of the Most High. Accept His name. Right? Who is He? The Most High in a man's body. That's His name. Yeshua. The only man that fulfilled His own word. Verse 14. And this is the confidence that we have in him, that if we ask anything according to his will, he heareth us. Not that we ask anything. What is it we're going to ask? We're going to ask that our brother is saved. Let's read on. This had nothing to do with co-creating our own reality. The secret and law of attraction. In other words, we can have anything we want. All we have to do is just put our intentions out there in the universe, and the universe will give us whatever we want. That's all based on the knowledge of the tree of good and evil. And it springs from trying to do what only the Most High can do. Only the Most High can do whatever he wants and get whatever he wants. Anybody that thinks they can be like the Most High is just falling for the trick of the devil. And that was the very thing that got Satan kicked out with, trying to be like the Most High. Read Isaiah chapter 14, verse 11 through 14. See what he did. Go to Ezekiel chapter 28, verse 11. Read that story and see why he did it. It was because of his beauty. In other words, his brightness. Oh, I'm so bright. I'm almost as bright as the Most High. My light's just as bright as him. I can take over. Oh. 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 All right, verse 14. And this is the confidence that we have in, that we ask anything according to his will. Now, that's the key. According to his will. What's his will? That every man be saved. Every man? Or just those who he chose to be saved? The ones that he created as vessels of honor. Because he created 99% of all people to be vessels of destruction. Oh. And if we know that he hears us, whatever we ask, we know that we had the petitions and the desires of him. If any man see his brother sin a sin that is not unto death, now he starts going into his brother. This is, he knows how he connects that ask anything you want to your brother. So, anyone that sees his brother commit a sin that's not unto death, he shall ask, and he shall give him life for them that sin not unto death. There is a sin unto death, and I say you don't pray for that. Okay, now what's he saying here? If any man sees his brother to commit the sin, right, that's not unto death. So what's that describing? In other words, the Most High created all mankind. He created some as vessels of honor, some as vessels of destruction. Right? And we don't know who is who, so we pray for everybody. Right? So any man, in other words, any man that sees his brother sin a sin, in other words, when you see your brother, we're going to be seeing our brother all the time. So while you're seeing your brother, and he's in that old sin, in that old commit a sin, thus committing the sin in his life, right? And he was chosen to go to eternal life. He's not going to go to eternal death, even though right now he's committing the sin, and he's in danger of going to eternal death. But because he was called, he's not going to go there, right? And your prayer is part of the calling to help him to see the truth, right? He shall ask and give him life, right? For them that sin not unto death. In other words, those that were created as vessels of honor. There is a sin unto death. I do not say you should pray for that. In other words, those who are continuing in the sin and the Most High wants them to go to eternal death, because they're going to be examples to show his great power. Those who try to be like him, they get punished. All right? Though we don't really know who those people are, right? He's saying, don't pray that they'll never go there, right, to eternal death, because 99% of them are made to go for eternal death. So don't pray that that won't happen. Don't pray that they're not going to go to eternal death. All unrighteousness is sin, right? All unrighteousness is sin, and there is a sin not unto death, right? And I just explained that. The sin not unto death is those that are participating in the sin that were created as vessels of honor to hear the message to save their lives, so it pulls them out of the sin. Now they're not going to eternal death. So even though they committed the sin, they've been pulled out, so they're not going to eternal death. That's what he's talking about. Okay. We know that that whoever is born of the Most High sinneth not. All right? In other words, we know that whoever is born of the Most High does not commit the sin anymore. Once the scales are dropped from the eyes, realize, oh, we're not trying to love our neighbors ourselves anymore. We have a brand new command, love one another. And the way we love one another is speak the truth out of our mouth about the sin to one another. Because that's the only way we can